Okay, so hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm doing a full guide on mods for Euro Truck Simulator 2. Right from installation, well, downloads from the websites, to playing in the game. Let's get started. So, here we are, my computer, and we're going to, so first of all you're going to whatever your preferred internet browser is. I'm going to Google Chrome, because why not, and you want to search what website you're going to get the mods from. I usually use ets2.lt, but whatever you want. Probably the most trusted website. Hang on a minute. So today we're going to be downloading a truck mod, and I'm going to show you how to get it in the game and stuff like that. But first of all, because I've already got this mod downloaded, let's delete it. So, so today I'm going to be downloading the Peterbilt 389. Pretty good mod, highly detailed. Oh, it's perfect. And we want to find the truck mod, which is this one here. Upgrade the Peterbilt 389 version 2.0.5. for ets2 1.25. Now here there are two download options: share mods, artwork files. Let's go share mods, and you don't need the website anymore either, just the share mods page, and download it. Come on, this one. And it's downloading down the corner. Don't know how long that's going to take. So while we're waiting for that to download, I'm just going to explain a few things. So, mods in Euro Truck Simulator 2 are pretty much anything that changes the game. Let me show you. So, ets2.lt. So if you go to the ets2.lt website, the main page you go through, it's just pages and pages of mods. So like maps, trucks, trailers. And then down the side you got mod categories, so this is basically what I mean. You got truck mods, which is like the Peterbilt we're downloading. You got trailer mods. Let's just check out trailer mods. So that's all trailers that you'll be in game, so like different trailers. Interior mods, so like coloured interiors and stuff. Interior add-ons, so like decorations. Tuning mods, lights, and stuff like that. AI traffic, that's pretty much all the vehicles in the game. Sound mods, that's like your engine sounds, indicators, horns, all that sort of stuff. Truck skins, that's paint jobs on trucks. Combo skin packs, I'm not sure what that is. So that's like truck and trailer, so that the companies match. Got maps, so when you first get the game, you got the standard SES map. But the map mods, you can change the maps, so it's like Russia, Australia, whatever. And then others, which is pretty much just everything else. So you got the fairies pack, don't know what that is. TomTom navigation, that sounds like pretty cool, I can download that on there. Cars. So, that's pretty much what that is. Like I said, a mod changes everything in the game. Mod is short for modification. What else are you going to need for mods? First of all, you need a copy of the game. I'm not sure if it works with the this version from like EB Games or something, but it definitely does work with Steam version of the game. And you're like, oh yeah, so I've got 445 hours of the game. And on Steam, I'm gonna go to the store. Ooh, it loads. Here we go. On Steam, it costs. I'm just gonna see how much the game costs. Euro Truck Simulator 2, Switch. It costs $19.99 USD, so US dollars. That's how much it costs on Steam. What else are you going to need? You are going to need a copy of WinRAR. Or is WinZip, I think it is. That basically, it's like an archive of everything that you got on your computer. And basically, that's where you're going to go to find the mod once you've done it. So, let's see how this is going. Yeah, it's getting there. So, WinRAR. This one here, the download. So you got WinRAR here. This is another like Robert Rosa. Okay, yeah, it is. So you go to download WinRAR. Actually, hang on. Make sure you download it for the OS you're using, the operating system on your computer. Be that 32-bit or 64-bit. And basically that, what that does is you'll be able to find the SCS file which goes into the mod folder of Euro Truck Simulator 2. Where is that? Documents. Reload. Mods. And this is basically your mod folder. I've got lots of mods installed. Now, how do you get into the mods folder, you may ask? Go to your documents, and when you have Euro Truck Simulator 2 installed, it'll simply come up with the Euro Truck Simulator 2 folder in your documents. Double click on that, and one of those folders will be a mod folder. Slight problem, I don't know why this happens. When I downloaded Euro Truck Simulator 2, the Euro Truck Simulator 2 folder came up in documents, and when I went into it, there was no mod folder. Don't know why. When in the game, yep, there's definitely a mod manager. Don't know. All you gotta do is just click, just right click and click. Wherever you go, it might be different on some operating systems. Wherever you go to create a new folder, so like new, you go folder, name that folder mod. And boom, you got a mod folder. All good. So that's where your SES files go. How's this going? It's getting there. I'm just going to show you what it's like in game. So when you go into Euro Truck Simulator 2, assuming you're up to date, it'll come up with this launchpad. Just basically everything. So you get your profiles here, and select your profile summary here, and mod manager. Mod manager is basically where all your mods are that you've got installed. So, that's pretty much everything that you've got installed. It only shows the things that are in your mod folder. So say I've got the Max Superliner installed. You click on the Max Superliner over here, you click this arrow here, and it'll activate the mod. To deactivate the mod, you just click it again. Click the back. Basically, what activating mod is, it activates the mod in game. Let's exit out of here. 360 of the game. So I'm pretty sure that's all we need. What else is there I can say? Oh, if you have a different version of... depending on the version of the game, some mods won't work. So this mod we're downloading now, the Peterbilt 389. Oh, I can't spell again. Where is it? As you can see, it says 1.25. That means it'll work with 1.25, definitely. It'll probably work with above, so like 1.26 above. So 1.25 above. Might work with some versions below 1.25, so 1.24. Not sure about that, they never tested it. Compared to if you go to like a mod like Kenworth W900L, like this one here, it'll say, or should say, maybe not. Try a different one. So this game, this mod here, the Kenworth W900L custom fuel tank. Makes it hold 1600 litres. It'll say tested on version 1.22 of the game. So it might not work with other versions of the games. Sorry, higher above. How can you know if it doesn't work? Well, first of all, this is 1.22, I'm on 1.26. But I'm pretty sure it works. Haven't tested it. No, it works to 1.25. Yes, I know. When you go into the game, it'll probably crash if you try to use a mod. The game will probably crash. Probably go to your home screen. Come up with a little box. Steam will stop working or something. So this will let you know that. Download's getting there. It's almost half done. So I'm pretty sure that's everything you need to know about that. One other thing, let's go back into WinRAR. Certain mods will have more SES files than other mods. So, say we got the Kenworth W900L here. It only has one SES file. That's the file you put into the mods folder when you're using a mod. You got the truck mods here. That's like a picture of the truck, just so you know what you're getting. And you got the... that's a template if you want to make a skin for the truck, which is a paint job. Which is basically a paint job. Whereas compared to, let's say, the Kenworth T908 has 1, 2, 3, 4 SES files. So you got part 1, part 2. All 4 have to go into the mods folder. If you activate part 1 and part 2 into the game, it'll work fine. If you activate part 1 into the game, it'll probably crash. I haven't tested it myself. If you activate part 1, part 2, and then the other two, which is the part 3 and part 4, it'll work fine. Don't need part 3 and part 4 for the game to mod to work, but you do need part 1 and part 2. If you activate part 4 and part 3, but not part 1 and part 2, it won't work, because there's no truck folder there. Just to let you know that. Usually most mods come with a README file, which you get there. Eventually. Which eventually, so this is basically a whole bunch of information. Holy crap, half of that's not even English. Let's see if the other one's English. Looks like it. Yep, this is English. So it basically goes through, it tells you all the authors for the mod, so you got Stas 556, Critch Bomb, Fireblade, all everyone else. And it also tells you what they did. So, like, what part of them, what they did. Description. It's the Kenworth T908. It is registered in the Order Iveco. So the Iveco dealership in game, that's where you're going to go to find the truck. It is found in the company's orders, present in the gallery tractors. So there's a truck gallery, like, you can customise it, see what it's like. So it's there. Has the real engines, so in real life you've got, like, the Cat C15, Cummins ISX, Packer, all those sort of trucks, Cummins N14. They're all real engines, so they'll be in there. Transmissions, you've got the Eaton Fuller 18-speed Road Ranger, all those sort of mods, main transmissions. So they're real. You've got real sounds, so what the Cat sound like, what the Cummins sound like, what the Packer sound like. Interior cabin with right hand and left hand drive. So that means you can either have the steering wheel on the left or the steering wheel on the right. I'll also tell you what's added with the latest version of the mod. And sometimes truck developers, mod developers don't want their mods shared. This is a paid mod, so they don't want you to share it, make it free. So when it gets there, we'll be right. And I'll just get it back in the computer. My documents were set. So, meanwhile, I'm still waiting for this to load. I'm just going to show you some stuff in Euro Truck Simulator 2. So currently in ets2, the mods I've got activated are the 11 USA trucks, adds 11 different trucks into the game, and the Dole 4-axis flatbed trailer. So now, I'm going to go in-game. And we're going to go to the About and the Truck Browser. That's where we want to go. So this is basically what I was talking about before. You can see, like, what the mods, like, how you can tune them and stuff. We're going to go with, I don't know, let's say, Kenworth T800. It's the Kenworth T800. Stop. You can change the cabs. So you've got day cab sleeper and the high rise sleeper. You can change the chassis. I don't know if they're changing this version of the mod. So you got the day cab chassis. Real different. Engines, Cats, Packers, Cummins. Transmissions, Eaton Fullers, Allisons, Merittas. And they're like 13, 10s, 18 speeds. 16 speeds. Chase interiors. So you got modern interior, classic interior. Chase paint jobs. Purple. Pink. Don't know how that's pink. That's more of a purple. That's more pink. Damn. You got metallic colours. And you got, like, paint jobs. As you can see. You can change everything from, so, like, bumpers, bar work, you can add Lights, air horns. I'm trying to get that dot. Bug deflectors, mirrors, sun visors. That's pretty cool. The other mirrors. You can add lights on the roof. Lights. Air horns. Lights on the roof up here. Oh, you can add like roof rack. Yeah, lights on the roof up here. Smoke. You can add the exhaust. You can change the tires. Got a whole list of tires here. Change the rims. Got a whole list of rims. You can change anything really. And then you go inside. Change steering wheels. That was pretty cool, personally. Never actually used that sort of steering wheel. All sorts of stuff. And like, fridge, passenger. All sorts of things. Just gonna leave out of the game. See how this downloads here. It's getting there. So that's basically everything regarding a mod. So this for this video, say we've downloaded it, it's not completely finished or anything. Let's just say we've downloaded it. If you went into, where is it? WinRAR. I'm just gonna put that mod back in there. So we go back into here. Should be in here now. Yep. Now you want to find your mod. This mod downloaded straight from the internet as an STS file. You got everything in it. So like, picture of it. Here's your manifest, I don't know what that is. There's all the things for the mod. Other mods, you got to go into a folder and then get the STS file. So when you download it, when you want P2.389, you need to go into the documents, into Euro Truck Simulator 2, into the mod folder. And basically what you want to do is you want to grab that SES file and bring it and just drag it into the mod folder. Let it download. It's loading into the mod folder. There we go. Now close the mod folder, close WinRAR. Open Euro Truck Simulator 2. Go into your mod manager. And the new mod will be at the top of the list. Click on it, which is the 389 Peterbilt. Click that arrow, which activates it in-game. Click Confirm Changes at the bottom of the screen. Also, you'll notice in the list, there's a green light that will come up. It says Active. This means the mod's active. And continue game into the profile of your choice. That truck will always be there. And this mod is found in the Iveco dealership, which you go to the truck dealers, you go to Iveco, and you go to the truck dealer. But I'm doing a job at the moment in the game, so I can't do that. I gotta finish the job first. Or you can go to About, Truck Browser, you find that mod, which is 389. Something's not right. Wrong 389, what's this one? And you can go about, you can customize everything. So basically, that's everything you need to know about mods in Euro Truck Simulator 2. I've gone from downloading the mod to showing you everything about mods, getting the mods in the game, and what mods do in game. That's pretty much all. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Watch out for more. Cha-ching!